We are discussing the chapter number 2, that is polynomials. The algebraic expression, we have studied about this, how to add them, subtract them, multiply them and divide them, and how to factorize them. You might have recalled the algebraic identities like x plus 1 y whole square, that is x square plus y square plus 2xy. X minus y whole square is x square plus y square minus 2xy, and this is a minus b a plus b, that is a square minus b square, that is x square minus y square is equal to x plus y into x minus y. This is the factorization. Okay, now here we will talk about polynomial on all the terminology which is related to it. We will see the remainder theorem and the factor theorem and how these will be applied to factorize the polynomial. And also we'll see the identities, some algebraic identities, and now we'll use these algebraic identities in factorization. And also some expressions are there by which using these identities we can evaluate them. Polynomials in one variable. One variable means 2x. So this is a polynomial, right? And it has one variable only. It is one variable. We denote the variable by x, y, z. This is trivial, traditional. So 2x, 3x, minus x, minus half x, these are all algebraic expression. And these are of the form a constant into x. That is 2x. When we say minus half x, minus half or minus 1 by 2 is a constant. Right? So we don't know what a constant is if we just write x and say k. Right? What is constant? So in this case, the constant can be a, b, c, k, anything like this. Say ax. But there is a difference between letter denoting a constant and a letter denoting a variable. The values of the constant remain same throughout a particular situation. So constant will not change. If you say 2 will change, it will not change. If you add 2x and 3x, 2 will not change. But the result of this will be 5x. But 2 will remain like this. But the constant, if it is not changing, the variable keeps changing. The x will change because, see, this is 2x. You write 2x. What value you can put? At x, you can put 2. So 2 into 2 will be 4. If you put x equal to, say, 1 by 6. So 1 by 6, 2, 3 is 6. So it will be 1 by 3. But 2 will always remain there. Only these values, these are x, representing x, will change. Consider a square which is 3 units. So what is the parameter? 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3. If you just walk around the boundary, the distance you have traveled is the parameter. So the best way is to find out what? This is 3 and this is 4 sides. So 4 into 3, right? 4 into 3. Now, if I write 4 into side, then depending upon what is the side, any perimeter can be found out. See, 4s I have written. Let us name s as x. So it will be like a variable. So if you come up and say the side is 10, I can easily tell you 4 into 10 is the 40 is the perimeter of the square. This is how this x varies. How to find out the area now? See, this is the side x, 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 x. So you say x into x is the area. That is x square. Now this x square, if you come up with any value, say 2 is the side. So x square, that is 2 into 2, that is 4 will be the area. You say 10 is the side, so 10 into 2, 10 into 10, sorry. So it will be 100. Okay. So algebraic expression, what we have considered, has only whole numbers as the exponents of the variable. That is x, x square, x cube, this is x to the power 1, like this. Polynomial exponents are in the form of only whole numbers. X to the power 0 is also, you know, because 0 is also a whole number, this is equal to 1. But x to the power 0 can be written. So these expressions are known as polynomials in one variable. See, polynomial in one variable. So you have one variable here, x, x square, or any type of thing. So see, this one, x cube minus x square plus 4x plus 7. So 7x to the power 0, x to the power 1, x to the power 2, x to the power 3 is there. Constant is 1, minus 1, 4 and 7. But we only have x here, no y, no y here. 3y square plus 5y, again a polynomial variable. In the variable, the variable is y. T square plus 4, the variable is t. Variable is t. So in this x square plus 2x, x square is one term, 2x is the other term. In the polynomial these, 3y square plus 5y plus 7, one is 3y square, other is 5y and other is 7. So there are three terms here. In this we have four terms, 1, 2, 3, 4, so minus x cube, 4x square, 7x and minus 2. There are four in polynomial, this polynomial we have four terms. So each term of a polynomial has a coefficient. For example, the coefficient of x cube is minus 1, coefficient of x square is 4, coefficient of x is 7, coefficient of x to the power 0, because x to the power is 0 is 1, the coefficient is or constant is minus 2. Okay, that is why we have written x to the power 0. Now, this coefficient means anything which is with the variable. Even if it is not there, it is 1. Right? If I just write 2, that means it is 2x to the power 0 because x to the power is 1. Right? 2x to the power 0 like this, which is actually equal to 2, these are called constant polynomial. What is this called? Constant polynomial. If I write 0, this is called a 0 polynomial. Now let us consider algebraic expression of this form, x plus 1 by x. We have seen x plus x square. But x plus 1 by x is what? Root x is also there. Cube root of y can be there. So x plus 1 by x can be written as x to the power minus 1. We know that. So this is x plus x to the power minus 1. Now here the exponent in the second term is minus 1, which is not a whole number. So this expression is not a polynomial. Similar with this, this is y to the power 1 by 3 plus y square. Y by 3 is not a whole number, that is why it is not a polynomial. See, this root x to the power half is not a whole number. It has to be a whole number, that is why these are not polynomial. Please understand, they are not polynomial. So if the variable in a polynomial is x, we denote the polynomial by px. So variable is x, we denote by px, or you can write qx also or rx also. So it can be written like this, px, qx or rx. Px, that means because this x is a variable, this is a polynomial. This is again a polynomial because we have y here, so we write ry. Because we have u as a variable, so we write su. So the polynomial can have any number of terms. See, this is also a polynomial. It has x to the power 150. Means x to the power n can be any whole number. So this if I just write in short, this polynomial contains 151 terms. If you take 2x, 2, 5x square, 5 minus 5x square, y, u to the power 4, all of these polynomials have only one term, right? That is why they are called as monomials. Mono means one. So these are monomials because they have only one term. In this, we have one term, two term. So two term. These are called binomials. Bi means two. In this, we have how many terms? 1, 2, 3. So they are called trinomials because tri means three, right? So any polynomial, if we write like this, 3 to x to the power 7, this one, the highest power is what? You see, the highest power is x to the power 7. The coefficient, the exponent of x, the highest exponent of the power is 7. In this, highest power is 6. This highest power of any polynomial is known as the degree of the polynomial. So degree of this is 7, highest power. Degree of this polynomial is 6 because highest power of y is 6. So the degree of non-zero constant polynomial is 0. Degree of non-zero constant polynomial is 0 because if you write 2, it means 2x to the power 0, the degree is 0. Find the degree of each of the polynomial given below. So this is 5 because highest power is 5. This is y to the power 8, highest power is 8. This is 2x to the power 0, so highest power is 0. Okay. Now just understand this 4x plus 5, 2y, t plus root 2. The degree of each of them is 1, x to the power 1, y to the power 1, t to the power 1. So these are linear polynomial. A polynomial with degree 1, these three are linear polynomial. You can also have three terms with x, the highest power is x to the power 1. That means it is a linear polynomial. So anything of the form ax plus b, x to the power is 1, highest power is 1, ax plus b form is always linear polynomial. This is linear polynomial with x. This is linear polynomial with y, ay plus b. This polynomial, 2x square plus 5, what is the highest degree? 2. These are quadratic polynomials. Here also, y square, power 2, highest power is 2. Highest exponent of y is 2. That is why they are called as quadratic polynomial. So anything of the form ax square plus bx plus c, where a should not be equal to 0 and a, b, c are constant here, they are known as quadratic polynomial. You can write in y form also, ay square plus by plus c. Please understand, a cannot be 0. If a is 0, then it will reduce to a linear polynomial. Now see these terms, 4x cube, highest power 3. These are cubic polynomial. So any expression of the form ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d, this a should not be 0 because ax cube will be 0, that will not be cubic polynomial. So a cannot be 0 and a, b, c, d, they have to be constant. These are known as cubic polynomial. Degree 1, degree 2, degree 3 you have seen. Now up to how many degrees we can go? There are infinitely many numbers you can find out because whole numbers are infinite. So let us write the polynomial in a general form. So polynomial of one variable x of degree n in the expression form is simply a, these an, an minus 1, these all are constant. So x to the power n, and the power is reducing, x to the power n minus 1 till the power x to the power 0 we go. This a1 to an, these are constants, these are all constants, and we get, if all these are 0, we get a 0 polynomial. But this is the general form of any polynomial. The degree of 0 polynomial is not defined, please understand. 0 means nothing, there is no degree. Because even if you write 0 to the power x to the power 0, it doesn't show anything. Okay. X or y or t, you have seen all the polynomials with maximum one variable. Now x square plus y square plus x, y, z. Now we have x also, y also, z also. That means we have three variables here. P, Q, R, three variables here. P, Q, R. Here you have U, V. So you have more than one variable. Here specifically three variable, and we have two variable. Zeros of a polynomial. What is zeros of a polynomial? For any value of x, if this polynomial becomes 0, we call it as a zero of that polynomial. If I put 1 in the place of x, if I put 1, I get a 4. If you just compute it, you get a 4. So 1 is not a 0. 1 is not a 0. But if I put x equal to 1, means x equal to 0, sorry. X equal to 1 is not a 0. If I put x equal to 0, I get minus 2. 0 is also not the 0 of a polynomial. Let us find out putting x equal to minus 1. See, I'll take you with an example. We have a proper example with that. So this one, 5x square minus 3x plus 7, we have to find which value of this at x equal to 1. What is the value of this? Let us see. We have to put x equal to 1 here. X equal to 1 square is 1, 3 into 1 is 1, 7. You add this, you get 1. This is the value at x equal to 1. How about y equal to 2 for this value? Just put y equal to 2 here, 2 cube, 2, and you just have to multiply, you get this one. How about t equal to a? Just put t equal to a here. What do you get? This value. So px equal to x minus 1, as I said, the 0 of this number, if I put x equal to 1, 1 minus 1 will be 0. So 0 of this expression, algebraic expression or you can say a monomial is 0. So P1 equal to 0, which any number which makes this expression as 0 is called the 0 of that polynomial. So in this case, 1 is a polynomial. If I write x minus 2, I put 2, 2 minus 2 is 0, so 2 is the 0 of that polynomial. I hope you got the idea. Also, if x minus 1 equal to 0, if I put x minus 1 equal to 0, say here, x will be equal to 1. This x equal to 1 is known as the root of that polynomial. X equal to 1 is the root of polynomial. If I write just x minus 2 equal to 0, x will be equal to 2. So x equal to 2 is the root of this polynomial. Okay. Now just consider a constant polynomial 5. Can you say what is the 0? It has no 0. Because this is a constant, there is no x to put some value to make it 0. A constant number cannot be a 0. So a non-zero constant polynomial like this has no 0. A non-zero constant polynomial has no 0. How about the zeros of a 0 polynomial? Every real number is a 0 of the 0 polynomial. 0 polynomial means 0. So every real number is a, you put any value. So every real number is a 0 of 0 polynomial. We have to check whether minus 2 and 2 are zeros of this polynomial. Put minus 2 here, put 2 here. Let us find out whether this expression becomes 0 or not. If you put 2, you get 4. If you put minus 2, you get 0. So minus 2 is the 0 of this expression x plus 2. Find the 0 of the polynomial 2x plus 1. So how to find out? Just put it as 0. 2x will be equal to minus 1, x will be equal to minus half. X equal to minus half is the 0 of this polynomial. Okay. So for any expression, linear expression like this, if you want to find the 0, just put ax plus b equal to 0. You will get the x. X will be equal to, say, minus b by a in this case, and this will be equal to 0. See, ax plus equal to 0, b will come here, minus b, x will be minus b by a, so x equal to minus b by a is the 0. So a linear polynomial has only one and only one 0. Linear polynomial, because it is only x to the power 1. Right? So we can say that 0 of x minus 1 is 1, minus 2 is the x is 0 of x plus 2, because minus 2 plus 2 equal to 0. So minus 2 is the 0 of this. We have to verify whether 2 and 0 are zeros of x square minus 2x or not. Let us put 2 here, 2 square minus 2 into 2, that is 0. And again put 0, 0 square minus 2 into 0 is 0. So both are the zeros of this polynomial. So what we got? In the linear polynomial, we got only one 0. But here this is not linear. This is binomial, you can say quadratic. So what we observe in this case is, the 0 of polynomial need not be 0. 0 may be a 0 of a polynomial as we just saw. And every linear polynomial has one and only one 0, but a polynomial can have more than one 0. A linear polynomial, only one 0, but a polynomial like this term, which is actually a binomial, can have more than one 0. Remainder theorem. Just consider two number 15 and 6. When I divide 15 by 6, I get 5, 6, 2's are 12. I get remainder as 3. So how can I write 15? I can write 15 is equal to 2 into 6 like this plus the remainder. Okay. So the remainder 3 is less than the divisor 6. That is why it didn't divide. Now if I divide 12 by 6, 6 by 12, 6 2s are 12, I get 0. So 12 can be written as 6 into 2 plus 0 like this. Same way we wrote here. So what is the remainder here? Remainder is 0. When the remainder is 0, we say that 12 is a multiple of 6. When the remainder is not 0, we say that 15 is not the multiple of 6. I hope you got the idea. Now, let us come to the polynomials. Let us try to divide it with a polynomial. 2x cubed plus x square plus x divided by x. That means we have to divide each term. So 2x cubed by x, x square by x, x by x. You get x, this, the x to the power a, x to the power b, it will give you x to the power a minus b. So what we have done, we have subtracted the power of numerator and denominator exponents. Now this will be x square, this will be x, and this will be 1. 2x square plus x plus 1, That means when I divide this polynomial by a monomial, I get a remainder. So how can I write it? I can simply write this as, because it is actually, if you take x out, it is dividing it. So now this, I take x out, so this will be x into 2x square plus x plus 1. If I divide by x, it cancels out, so this is dividing it. So we say that x and these are factors of these, and 2x cube plus x square plus x is a multiple of x, as well as the multiple of 2x square plus x plus 1. I hope you got the idea. Now let us take this one. 3x square plus x plus 1 divided by x. So 3x square by x plus x by x plus 1 by x. Okay. Now in this case you get this one is what? We are dividing it by 3x. X cancels 1 plus 1 plus 1 by x. We see here we cannot divide 1 by x to get a polynomial term, because this is not a polynomial term. This 1 by x is equal to x to the power minus 1, and when the power is not a whole number, this will not be a polynomial. So now we have to use some remainder stuff. That is, 3x cube plus x plus 1 will be equal to 3x plus 1 into x plus 1. In this case, 3x plus 1 is the quotient. Similar way, 15 was equal to 6 into 2 plus 3. This is the remainder. This is divided when we divide. This is 2 into 6. So 6 we divide, and this is the 2 times it got divided. So now this is the remainder. Since the remainder is not 0, it will not be a factor. 15 divided by 6, because the remainder was 3, this is not a factor. I hope you got the idea. Let us see this with an example. Divide this by this. So what we have to do here is, we write the dividend and the divisor 1 plus x in the standard form. We need to rearrange them. We cannot just do it. 3x square has to come, means decreasing a power of x we have to write. 3x square has to be brought here, x has to be brought here. So this will be 3x square plus x minus 1. This has to be x plus 1. Now first we have to arrange them in the descending order of their degrees. So now this term will become 3x square plus x minus 1. This term will become x plus 1. Now this is okay. Now we can start the division. We divide the first term of the dividend by the first term of the divisor. Like 3x square is divided by x. We get what? 3x. This is the first term of the quotient of the How? Let me show you. I have 3x square plus x minus 1. I have x plus 1. Now I multiply x with some term so that I get 3x square. X into some term, say k, I have to get 3x square. This I have to multiply x with some term so that I get 3x square. So what will be k? 3x square by x, that is 3x. So I have to put 3x here. So now x plus 1, we have to write 3x here. So now 3x square. But 1 has to be also multiplied by 3x. This can be written here. Now let us subtract them. 3x square minus 3x square is 0. And this is 1. So 1 minus 3 is minus 2x. This is minus 1. We have to just lie here. Means just bring it down. Now, this x plus 1, again, we have to multiply x with some number so that I can get minus 2x. So x into k, I need to get minus 2x. So what will be k? Minus 2x by x. This will be minus 2. So I have to write minus 2 here. So this will be minus 2x. Minus 2x. Then 1 into minus 2 is minus 2. So now just subtract it. Right? When we subtract it, this goes down. And this will be minus 1 of minus 1 of minus 2. And this will be plus 1. So you get only 1. So what you get? Let me show you here. You get plus 1. So ultimately what you have got here is the term, this is x plus 1, 3x square plus x minus 1 was there. Now we took 3x minus 2. I know that you have got the idea, but still I will be taking for a few more example. But in this case, what was the remainder? Final remainder was 1. So you have a divisor, you have a quotient, you have a dividend and a remainder, which was 1. So finally, what we got? X plus 2, 3x minus 2, this is the remainder. So how this 3x square plus x plus 1, x minus 1 can be written as? The dividend has to be equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. And let us put it here. This is the divisor, this is the quotient, and this is the remainder. So 3x square plus x minus 1 can be written like this. I hope you got the idea. First, I have to reuse x. I have to put some number here so that x into 3x has to be 3x square, this number. Now we have to subtract whatever comes here, 1 into 3x, we have to subtract it, and minus 2x minus 1 comes. Now the next time I have to use some number so that I have to multiply x with some number so that I get minus 2x. So I have to put minus 2 here so that minus 2x I can get. So minus 2x is there. Now other number can be anything. So minus 2 is minus 2. When you subtract, we eliminate this, and minus 1 of minus of minus 2, that is minus 1 plus 2 is 1. This is how we write it. So any polynomial px can be written as gx into qx plus rx, and you know that this is the remainder, this is the quotient divisor, you know all about this. So in this equation, see, if I put, because my remainder was what, 1. So if we 3x square plus x minus 1, if we get, the divisor was a linear polynomial in this situation. So if we put x equal to minus 1 in this case, I get 1. X equal to minus 1. See, what is this x plus 1? X plus 1. X plus 1 I put equal to 0, so x equal to minus 1. So if I put x equal to minus 1 in this equation, that is 3x square plus x minus 1, I get a remainder 1. This is what I am saying. So when I put x equal to minus 1, because I have to divide this by x plus 1. So the root of x plus 1 is minus 1. And when I put minus 1 in here, I have to get a remainder as 1. Let us take more examples so that you understand better. Now, first is this, if you put x equal to 1, x minus 1 equal to 0, so x equal to 1, you should get this minus 5. But we start with the stepwise procedure. We have to divide 3x to the power 4 minus 4x cube minus 3x minus 1 divided by x minus 1. Okay. Now I have to multiply x with some number here, so that I get 3x to the power 4. So x into k, any number should be 3x cube. So k will be 3x cube by x, so 3x square. So I have to multiply 3x to the power 4. Sorry. So 3x cube I get. This is x, 3x to the power 4, so I get 3x cube. This is my k. So I have to put 3x cube here. Now I have to multiply this 3x cube by both of these terms and put just beneath this expression. So this will be 3x to the power 4. This will be minus 1 into 3x cube, that is minus 3x to the power cube. Now subtract this. 3x to the power 4, 3x to the power 4 will cancel. And minus 4 of minus, this is minus 4x cube minus of minus, that is 3. X cube, that will be equal to minus x cube. Now just bring this down. Minus x cube minus 3x square minus 1. Why I kept it away? Because I know that I will get some x square here. So let us see the second one. X minus 1, that is x, I have to put some here, some value here, so that I get minus x cube. So x into k has to be equal to minus x cube. So minus x cube. So what will be k? Minus x cube by x. So x minus x square. So this minus x square I have to write here. Now minus x square into x is minus x cube, minus x square into minus 1 is x square. Subtract this, you get x minus x square here, because sign will change, and minus 3x and minus 1 can be brought down. Now again, let me find out the value here, so that when I multiply it by x, I should get minus x square. So x into k has to be minus x square. I want this value. So k will be equal to minus x square by x, that is minus x. So I put minus x here. Now minus x into x, this will be minus x square, and minus x into minus 1, that will be equal to x. Okay. Subtract this, this will go minus 3 minus of minus 1, that is minus 4x. I will bring it down. Now I have to multiply x with some number so that I get minus 4x. So x with into some number, so I get minus 4x. K k will be equal to minus 4x by x, that is equal to minus 4. So I have to use minus 4 here. So x minus 4x, and minus 1 into minus 4 is 4. Subtract this, this will go minus 1 of minus 4 is minus 5. This is how we write. So now if you put x minus 1 equal to 0, that is x equal to 1, you put in this expression, you will get minus 5 as the remainder. Now the same thing, we want to divide x cube plus 1 by x plus 1. So x plus 1, x into x square will be x cube. So x square into 1 will be minus x, will be x square. Subtract this, this will go 1, this will be minus x square. Okay, we just have to write and take 1 also. So this will be minus x square plus 1. Now x into x, minus x will be minus x square. So minus x square cancels, minus x will remain like this when I bring down. Now x into 1 will be equal to 1. Now 1 has to be multiplied with 1, you get 1, minus minus, you get 0. So now x plus 1 is dividing this properly. Actually x plus 1 is a factor of this. If you put x equal to minus 1, x cube plus 1 will be equal to 0. If you put x equal to minus 1, this is 0. This shows that x plus 1 is a factor of x cube plus 1. Now let us talk about the remainder theorem, because we have seen the examples now. Let Px be any polynomial of degree which is greater than or equal to 1, and let it be any real number. Please see, if I am dividing Px by Qx, the power of Px has to be higher. It cannot be lower than Qx. Only then we can divide. So if Px is divided by a linear polynomial x minus a, the remainder is P, right? We have to find out the remainder when it is divided by x minus 1. So we don't have to do anything. We just put x minus 1 equal to 0, x will be equal to 1. 1 needs to be put at every place where x is. So 1 we are putting, we get 2. So by remainder theorem, the remainder of this expression when it is divided by x minus 1 is simply 2. Check whether the polynomial this is a multiple of 2t plus 1. 2t plus 1, so 2t plus 1 equal to 0. So this gives t equal to minus half, right? Now put t equal to minus half in this. If it is 0, if we put t equal to minus t by 2 minus half in this every t, if this becomes 0, then it is a multiple. So let us put minus 2 at every place of x. It is 0 indeed. So now we can say that this indeed is a multiple of this, right? So this is the first part of our discussion on polynomial. We'll be taking one more. Till then, thank you so much and take care of yourself.